Given a rule for a function and an output value for the dependent variable, it is possible to backtrack the rule to calculate the corresponding input value for the independent variable. What we're going to do is work forwards through the rule as normal, starting from the input value, and writing down in order each step that we would normally take to calculate the output value. And then underneath that, we're going to write down the output value and work our way backwards along the sequence of steps. We'll be executing the steps of the function in reverse order, and at each step, we'll have to do the inverse operation in order to undo the function rule one step at a time. We're going to do the opposite operations in the opposite order. Let me show you how this works. Suppose my function rule says the output equals 2 times the input minus 3. That is, whatever I put into my function rule, the output is 2 times that input value minus 3. But what if I know the output value is 9? What input value must I have put in to give me 9 as the output value? Well, just work backwards through the rule, undoing each step. 9 plus 3 is 12. 12 divided by 2 is 6. Therefore, the input value must have been 6 to get an output value of 9. Notice my use of the three dots in a triangle to mean therefore. Can I check this answer? Yes, of course. Substitute the input value of 6 into the original rule. 2 times 6 is 12, minus 3 is 9. Good. The next example is written with algebraic variables instead of input and output, to show you that you can use exactly the same process to solve equations written like this. Y equals 4x plus 7, and y, the output variable, equals 27. So we need to work out what value of x gives us a value of 27 for y. We're solving this equation for x. Well, if I did have a value for x, my input variable, what would I do with it in order to work out the value of y? Look at the rule. If I knew the value of x, what operations would I do in what order? First, I would multiply x by 4 and then add 7. Notice I'm being careful to make sure my letter x looks very different from my time sign. Now I can backtrack my rule. The output value, y, is 27. Now work backwards, doing the opposite operations in the opposite order. 27 minus 7 is 20, and 20 divided by 4 is 5. Therefore, an input value for x of 5 gives me an output value for y of 27. Let's check that answer by substituting it into the original rule again. 4 times 5 is 20, plus 7 is 27. Good. The thing is, this same method works even if you have quite a complicated expression, provided the unknown variable appears only once. This one has several steps, and notice how it's written without an explicit name for the output variable. But that's okay, it's easy to solve with backtracking. All you have to do is work out what operations are being done in what order. Think carefully through the order of operations. If you did have a value for n, what operations would you do? In what order? First, do the brackets, add 5. Then multiply by 3. Remember the time sign isn't written there, but that's what it means. 3 times everything in the brackets. Then subtract 6, and finally divide by 2. Now backtrack the rule. The output value is 9. 9 times 2 is 18. 18 plus 6 is 24. 24 divided by 3 is 8, and 8 minus 5 is 3. N must be 3 for that whole expression to evaluate to 9. Check it. 3 plus 5 is 8, times 3 is 24, minus 6 is 18, and 18 divided by 2 is 9, which is what we wanted. Good. For a final example, here's a problem that looks more like a real exam question, with several steps and lots of words. Let's work through it step by step. Ben has a savings plan that starts with $10. He saves $2 per week. A. Name the dependent and independent variables. B. Write a rule in symbol form to show the relationship between the two variables. C. Use your rule to calculate the amount saved after 8 weeks. And D. Backtrack your rule to determine how long it will take for Ben to save $100. Now you could solve part C and D using a graph instead of an algebraic rule. But I want to show you how you can use backtracking to answer a question like this. A. Name the dependent and independent variables. What are the two things in this problem that vary? There's the amount of money saved and the number of weeks. And the money saved depends on the number of weeks. If you get stuck trying to work out which one is dependent and which is independent, put them in a sentence like this. Notice I've included the units in the definition of the variable for the amount of money saved. I want to make sure I use it consistently. Now I could leave it like that, but part B says to write a rule in symbol form to show the relationship between the two variables. So first let's choose a symbol to represent each of these variables. Let's use M for money and W for weeks. So, what's my rule? The money saved, M, is equal to the $10 Ben starts with, plus $2 per week. Each week he saves $2. After 1 week he saved $2, after 2 weeks $4, after 3 weeks $6. That's just 2 times the number of weeks. M equals 10 plus 2W. C. Use your rule to calculate the amount saved after 8 weeks. Well, that's easy. Just substitute 8 for W, the number of weeks. M equals 10 plus 2 times 8, which is 26. Ben will have saved $26 after 8 weeks. And finally, D. Backtrack your rule to determine how long it will take for Ben to save $100. And my rule was M equals 10 plus 2W. Well, when we had a value for W, the number of weeks, what did we do with it? First, we multiplied it by 2, and then we added 10. Notice the order here matches the order we do the operations, starting with the variable W, which is not necessarily the order it's written in the rule. Work your way outwards starting from the independent variable, not just from what happens to appear on the left in the way the rule is written down. But here we have a value for M, how much Ben wants to save. It's $100. So backtrack the rule by doing the opposite operations in the opposite order. 100 minus 10 is 90, and 90 divided by 2 is 45. It is going to take Ben 45 weeks to save $100. Let's check that answer. Substitute 45 weeks for W in the rule. 10 plus 2 lots of 45 is 10 plus 90, which is 100. Good.